How's it going, guys? I apologize for part one and part two being a little distorted. I went on, my girlfriend had a conference and she had to borrow the laptop, so I had to tweak some stuff to get it back to less echo, back to all that other good stuff. But yeah, we're continuing on with part three. Pretty sad intro. This game just like hit me with pretty damn sad. I mean, losing his kids like that, and then 2 years has gone by, and you know, it seems like I don't know what happened, but like, but yeah, let's continue on. Looks like, you know, they're not really together anymore. I don't know. Seems like also their kid really broke them apart, so.
So, you want to talk a little?
Talk about
just
what?
Go for me.
I don't know about you, your friends. How things are going?
Nothing special.
If Sean is hungry, he can find something for himself. Grease has Sean this weekend. Seems like he can't wait to get back to his mother. Time for a snack. Maybe Sean is hungry. Sean hasn't done his homework yet. I wrote a reminder note on the board in the kitchen. It's still early. We'll see about the homework later.
Let's make him a snack first. Our fridge does not look that appetizing. Let's see here. We got some drink. It's for us. I'm gonna be drinking that now. I'm not in front of a kid. How do we make a snack? 4:30 snack. Okay, so let me make a snack first.
It's time for your snack. Are you hungry?
I guess, a little.
Let's see what we can find in the kitchen. How are things at school? Is your teacher nice?
Everything's fine, Dad.
Aww.
It's getting dark. Better turn on the light.
Here, Sean. Here's your snack.
Thanks, Dad.
Aww. Okay. Turn the light on for him. Light on. Light on. So time goes by pretty fast without even realizing it. So
Sean, do you want to do your homework now?
Please, Dad, let me watch TV a little while longer. We'll do it later, okay?
I think you should just get right to it. Then it's done and out of the way. Now, get your bag and get set up in the kitchen. I'll help you.
Aw, poor kid. Alright, well, got our snack, got the homework, 7 o'clock is dinner, so it's about to do, wow, that was fast. It's already almost 6:15. Alright, so he's getting to work on his homework. He needs to get started on dinner soon. 8 o'clock, he needs to be in bed. I guess I can help him. Okay, so it's almost 6:30. So can we start together early, or do you gotta wait? 7 o'clock is dinner, so check the fridge. And so we'll just go.
Finished. Go watch TV.
Oh, he's done with his homework. Nice.
Let me have a look. Pretty good. Looks like you're done. Off you go.
Look at that. Good job, Sean. I think my guy's name is Ethan. Look at Ethan doing, being a good dad. I don't know what happened prior to the 2 years to all this, but I mean, he's trying. Got his kid to do his homework before the tea.
It's dinner time. I better make something for Sean.
Gotta make dinner. Let's see, it's probably, it's almost 7 o'clock, so. 7 o'clock is dinner. It's almost dinner time, so where do I go? Play.
Do you want me to get your dinner?
Oh yeah, I'm really hungry.
Okay, I'll go see what I can find. I'll call you when it's ready.
So, I mean, you still gotta be a parent, still got responsibilities. There we go. So, let's see what we got. We got pizza or roasted chicken. Pizza's on a tray, roasted chicken's in a microwave dish. Either one is fine, I guess. Still counts, right? Gotta make do with what you have. It's the thought that counts, right? He's at least attempting to make dinner. Alright, so dinner's on the way. 8 o'clock is bed. Cut this open.
You can come now, Sean. Your meal is ready.
I'm coming.
So it's almost 8 o'clock. Dinner's ready now, so there we go. Do I need to make... I just need to make sure I take the shot, eh? So as long as this kid's taken care of, he's good. It seems like every step I make, time goes by, so... Now I just relax with Sean. 8 o'clock bed. Guess I can't really clean up anything. So now we got his 8 o'clock bedtime, so he can watch some cartoons for a little bit, let him be a kid and, you know, let him do his stuff. But, you know, as soon as it hits 8 o'clock, be like, it's bedtime, mister. No answer for books. There we go. Go to bed. Enjoy some more father-son TV time. Why not? Voodoo. Are you watching? Let's see what time is it. Almost 8 o'clock, so well, I've enjoyed his cartoons for a little bit. 7:55 now, so I guess we'll do in the morning.
Come on, Sean. It's time for bed.
I'm not tired yet. Can I stay up a little longer?
Not very reasonable, is it? You're due tomorrow. You have to get some sleep.
All right, I'm going. Are you coming with me?
Go brush your teeth and put on your pajamas. I'll come up.
I give Ethan credit. At least he's trying to be a good father. Probably so heartbroken by this. Off TV. So Ethan or Sean's off to bed. Right on time. So bedtime. We'll just go up. Got up, I want to go back. Turn on the light so we can see. What was that over there? You put that on the ground. Move the left, to the right. Up. That's a no.
When the parents came home from church, all their children were gone. They searched and called for them. They cried and begged, but it was all to no avail. Children have never been seen again.
That was a sketch. What was that from? Just a piece of mail? Turn the light on. Bathroom. Don't worry about us right now. Let's go worry about our kid. Looks like it's probably our bedroom, so guessing this is close.
Good night, Sean.
My teddy! I haven't got my teddy, Dad!
You must have left it somewhere in the house. Do you have any idea where it could be?
No, Dad. Please, I can't sleep without him.
All right, I'll have a look around and see if I can find it, okay?
He just wants his teddy. We gotta go find him his teddy bear. What's in here? We got, it's like a study for his work. Whatever he does. Okay. Where is the teddy bear now? That is an apple. You can't sleep without his teddy. Teddy. I just come from a circle, I guess, okay. The origami killer strikes again. Origami killer? I wonder if that has any ties to his son. Well, this is another bathroom. I don't see any teddy bear. Let's go check. I'm sure he gets nightmares and wants to sleep with daddy from time to time or something. Lay in his bed. You know, all little kids get scared. So let's go check our bed. He's missing his teddy bear, so let's go see. Where's the light at this place? We need a light. There we go. Turn the light on. Let's check our bedroom.
Sean wants his teddy. He must have left it lying around here somewhere. It was in the laundry room the last time I saw it.
Okay, the laundry room. What is this? Study / laundry room? Aw, dang it. We're on a mission to find a fruit pie. Okay, mess around if that works. Okay, so bathroom is right over there. I don't know this dude's house. I barely even knew the bigger other one that they had. This is like, is this laundry? Oh, there's Teddy. Is there a teddy bear? Yeah, it's a teddy bear. Okay. Camera angles. Gotta remember that. We got Teddy. Sean can go to sleep. Nice and sound. Here we go, buddy. blanket. Is that it? Does your teddy just chill with you on the end of your bed? Okay. Thought you'd be sleeping with it, but that works for me as long as you have your teddy bear. My child. Wait. Oh. Let me turn off the light or anything. Okay, it's just the dark. So that's good. I can tell he's daydreaming or... Press touchpad to access the control screen. Tuesday. Is that 12 a.m.? Heavy rain. Thoughts. Oh, that's how to do the controls. Okay. Wait, is someone else now? So we don't just play as Ethan, we play as other people too. That's really cool. I'm used to like Until Dawn. Well, Until Dawn has like multiple roles, but they're all right next to each other. I wonder who this guy is.
Been looking for weeks. Hope I hit pay dirt this time. Man at the desk gotta be able to help. Guess I better take the stairs.
Lauren Winter. Ring any bells?
Nope. Can't say it does.
This guy sounds like a slight detective. The way he was, his thought patterns were.
Oh, that one. Third floor, last door on the left at the end of the corridor.
He just totally paid someone off to get information. Nice. That's why we came. Last one left. This is the last one left.
Lauren Winter.
Sorry, I only declined by appointment. It's $50. I don't kiss and I don't do any weird shit.
Fine by me.
Put your money on the table. You've got exactly 10 minutes when the alarm rings, it's over, okay?
Definitely a prostitute.
You should take your clothes off. We ain't got all day.
Actually, I'm not a customer.
Oh, shit, my cop. I should have known. What do you want? A freebie? Is that it?
My name is Scott Shelby. I'm a private detective. The families of the victims of the Origami Killer asked me to investigate the murders. I came here just to ask you some questions about them.
I already told the police all I know and have nothing to add. Leave me alone.
I understand, Lauren. I know what you're going
through. Oh yeah? You know what it feels like to find your own son's body on a wasteland? I'm sorry, I don't believe you have the slightest idea what I'm going through, Mr. Shelby.
The killer is walking around free as we speak. He'll kill again if he's not arrested.
Your son is dead, so what difference does it make?
I bought 10 minutes of your time, didn't I? All I ask is that you use that time to answer some questions.
You pay me to tell you about my son, is that it? You can buy my body, Mr. Shelby, but my son is not for sale. Get out of here. Get the fuck out!
Well, if you remember anything, the smallest detail, give me a call.
Well, guys, that wraps up this one. Stay tuned for part 4 of Heavy Rain. This is my first time ever dabbling into a role-playing game like this, so it's pretty intriguing. I don't know the whole part of this Origami Killer, but it sounds like he's tied to something. I don't think it's tied to Ethan's son, because Ethan's son got hit by a car. But it sounds like there's this Origami Killer. But we'll figure out what's going on in the next video. And thanks for watching, guys. This is Razor Wrath. Be sure to comment, like, subscribe. Peace out.